Here we are again on Chronicles. It's Ben and me yet again for our for another three sessions. The other two are just too lazy to be able to do anything, I think. We're in Mark 10, and we've got this wonderful, wonderful little bit, this encounter with Jesus and children and the disciples and what he's saying here. So it's verse 13. People were bringing little children to Jesus for him to place his hands on them. But the disciples rebuked them. When Jesus saw this, he was indignant. He said to them, "Let the little children come to me and do not hinder them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. Truly I tell you, anyone who will not receive the kingdom of God like a little child will never enter it." And he took the children in his arms, placed his hands on them, and blessed them. Well, I mean, there's blessings and anger and indignation and tellings off and all kinds of things going on here, isn't
there? Being told off again. It wasn't long ago that they came to Jesus and said, "We saw a guy preaching in your name, but we told him to stop." And now they're quite interesting disciples. They often act, don't they, thinking they're acting rightly.
Yeah.
But they've got worldly sort of thinking, haven't they?
That's why we learn from them, though, isn't it?
Hmm.
Because they're us, basically.
Yeah.
Because I don't think we're above them.
No.
And so this is how you learn from the Bible, isn't it? You don't place yourself above them. You say, "Well, actually, I probably would have done that."
Yeah.
So the thinking of the day is very different in how we think of children. So children tend to be, you know, our idols, the big thing. They're the most important thing. We sort of talk about them like that. Even though we may not actually behave towards children like that, that's how we think.
Yeah.
Here, children are really not that significant.
Right.
They're not that important. And to have someone like a rabbi, a teacher, you know, a teacher of God, he would teach the adults, but he didn't want the little children around.
Okay.
And so that's what's going on here. People, I guess parents, are bringing their children because there's something about Jesus that is attractive to the insignificant, the outcast. We already had in Jesus talking about in chapter 10 about the way men were treating women and because they were insignificant, I could divorce them and marry someone else. And he's furious about that.
Yeah.
And now you've got this same sort of thing with children.
Yeah. So the disciples are looking at this and going, "Hang on a minute, this is not how other rabbis behave."
Yeah.
Other rabbis, as you said, don't accept little children because they're insignificant. So Jesus wouldn't want the children to come to him. So what are you doing bringing children to Jesus? Go away. He doesn't want you.
Yeah. So they think they're doing the right thing.
Yeah.
Actually, this happened. I was in India and I was in little villages in India and the children came out because they'd not actually seen a white man.
Right.
So they all came out running around and a bloke came out.
And told them
a religious man with a stick and beat them away.
Really?
And I had to say, "Can you stop this?
Really?
This is not, you do not represent me."
Right.
So it sort of still happens in different cultures. And I guess that's what happened here.
I mean, maybe that's, thinking about how Christianity has influenced the way we think in, everything really in the West. Maybe it is Jesus that has got us to the point today where we dress little children up in those t-shirts and things that say little angel and but they're not though, are they?
No, we've gone sort of too far as it were. We've been influenced. Even our secularism has been influenced by Christianity. So here they come. Then it says that Jesus was indignant, and it's a very strong word in the original. He really is very angry about this,
right?
Because I think one, don't treat children like that. Two, you're not understanding.
Why are you stopping people coming to me?
Yeah.
That's the interesting thing.
Yeah. And then he says, "Let the little children come to me and do not hinder them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these." Now, this is where we've got to get our cultural differences. What he's saying is not, he goes on and says, "Truly I tell you, anyone who will not receive the kingdom of God like a little child can never enter it." This isn't good work stuff.
Right.
This isn't him saying, "You've got to become a lovely, trusting, innocent little child before you can come to God."
Because now suddenly you have to do something.
Yeah.
You've got to become a certain type of person.
Yeah.
You've got to try to be that before you can
get in. I think he's saying, you've got to realize that you have no standing, you're insignificant, you don't deserve to come.
Right. Yeah.
So the disciples are right and wrong.
Okay.
Yeah. because yeah, you can't come to God unless you're and unless you realize that you are a child, that actually you don't deserve to come.
Right.
But I'm all about that. Once you know that,
yes,
you can become a member of the kingdom of God.
Right. Which is actually more in line with loads of other stuff, you know. The kingdom of God belongs to you know, the humble and the poor in spirit, and those who don't think much, you know, who are humble and think of themselves as lowly.
Yeah. Blessed are the poor in spirit.
Yeah.
Blessed are the hungry and thirsty.
Yeah.
Those that haven't got.
Yes.
God's come for, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which is good, actually, because often if you went down the line of you have to be like a little child to enter the kingdom of God, it sort of means that you think less in some ways.
Yeah.
Don't ask questions, you know, just trust. That's what a little child does.
Yeah.
Except they don't, because they ask why thousands of times. That's not what a child
does. Yeah.
Yeah, a child doesn't just blindly accept things, do they? Why? Why?
So once you know that you don't deserve to come,
yeah,
God receives you.
Well, yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
It's you don't come because you deserve anything.
That's right, yeah.
And so this is what people have got to understand. The message of the Bible is for undeserving people like you and me.
Mm.
And once you get that, the kingdom of God is open to you.
Yeah.
Because you come to the one who can bless you,
yeah,
and place his hands on you.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's an interesting thing, isn't it? What is Jesus doing? What is he doing when he blesses them? Is he just saying, would you have a blessed life and be rich and be fruitful and be healthy? Or is there something more going on there?
I guess it's got to do with entering the kingdom of God.
Yeah.
So he's the one that blesses you,
yeah,
to bring you into the kingdom of God. And so his own saying in the Sermon on the Mount, it's not in Mark, is blessed are the poor in spirit, for they will receive the kingdom of God.
Mm.
And so the very blessing is that the undeserved,
yeah,
because of who Jesus is,
yeah,
and what he does on the cross, which we're not there quite yet, but he brings us in.
Mm.
Well, I guess we better finish there.
Yeah.